It's fantastic that the brand new series of Mad Men is coming to Sky Atlantic HD. Here in Los Angeles, I filmed an exclusive interview with the sexiest man on TV, Mad Men's magnificent lead character, Don Draper, played by the actor John Hamm.
Advertising is based on one thing. Happiness. And you know what happiness is? Happiness is the smell of a new car. It's freedom from fear. It's a billboard on the side of the road that screams with reassurance that whatever you're doing, it's okay.
Mad Men is set in a New York advertising agency at the start of the 60s. Don Draper is the rising star, and the series follows his career and complicated private life at a time when everything in America is about to change. John, it's probably a bit like asking Neil Armstrong to describe the application form for becoming an astronaut, but can you remember how you felt when you first saw the first script for Mad Men, when it was a possibility?
Oh, yeah, very vividly, in fact. I read it and really, really responded to the material and responded to the period and responded to the character and thought this could be something very special. And it was the first chapter in what promised to be a very long and very detailed and very intricate and very esoteric and interesting, deep story.
Did it feel like there was a lot of room for you to develop the character of Don Draper? I wonder how much he's changed since the first reading that you had.
Well, there's certainly a lot of ground, a lot of fertile ground to sort of farm. He's almost in many ways a blank slate, and you can project a lot of things onto him.
He walks a fine line because he's not necessarily a likable character, you know. He's a sort of serial adulterer, he's relentlessly ambitious, quite a chauvinist.
Part of the fun, I think, of watching characters that aren't necessarily always doing the right thing is having that bit of vicarious thrill of watching these people maybe not make the right choices.
And here I was just wishing for a man to help me with my yard work.
Do you like it?
You know, I do, honestly. I think he's misunderstood.
Of course.
I think he's doing the best with the very, very difficult and damaged foundation that all of this is lying on. And I think it's a little bit sort of fundamentally American, in the sense of he is, as you said, very ambitious.
Give me a pen. What do women want? Any excuse to get closer.
Thank God. There's that ego people pay to see.
He has constructed this persona and imbued it with enough personality and belief in the bullshit that it becomes real. And if there isn't a better metaphor for America than that, then I don't know what.
What you call love was invented by guys like me to sell nylons.
Who's the woman in the series that you gravitate towards most in terms of character? There's some very choice women to choose from.
I think the one who's had the longest and most interesting arc to me has been Elizabeth Moss, who is a character of Peggy, who we meet in the pilot, who comes as the new girl.
Hopefully, if you follow my lead, you can avoid some of the mistakes I've made here.
Hello, John.
Like that one.
It's been incredibly satisfying as a fan of the show, but also as someone who works on it to watch that dynamic shift.
Mr. Draper, I don't want to seem ungrateful, but I think I could serve Sterling Cooper and you better as a copywriter if I had my own desk.
You have a desk.
But now I have radio spots.
Peggy, the conversation of a raise is not inappropriate at this moment, but do not be timid. You presented like a man, now act like one.
Aside from people raving about your part, a lot of the praise for Mad Men is for the writing.
It's unlike a lot of shows on television, so I think that difference sets it apart. And it takes its time. It doesn't stoop to assume that the viewer doesn't understand what it's saying, and it doesn't spell everything out. So you're required as a viewer to sort of pay attention.
I bet daily friendship with that bottle attracts more people to advertising than any salary you could dream of.
That's why I got in.
So enjoy it.
Doing my best here.
One of the things about doing a period piece, it's a great way to sort of investigate what is going on in the culture. When there are the manners of not being able to talk about yourself, or the difference in sort of the personal expression, the attitude towards fame, the attitude towards women in the workplace, the attitude towards work itself, and just the different generations that I've tried to put in, you know, of the World War I generation, the World War II generation, the Korea generation that didn't go to war, then the Vietnam generation, and to see those forces working against each other.
People want to be told what to do so badly that they'll listen to anyone.
When you say people, I have a feeling you're talking about thou.
And I have a feeling that you spent more time on your hair this morning than she did.
I felt that this period had been forgotten. There was no casual Friday. There was a belief in presentation. And even if Peggy comes in to work in something that's from the 40s and she looks a little dowdy, she is dressed up to go to work.
We should be asking ourselves, what do women want?
I don't know. But I wish I had it.
The actors have pens and rings and lighters in their pockets. Their phones have to be off the set when they're working. I don't even want them feeling their, you know, their iPhone or their BlackBerry in their pocket. I want them to be in it, and they love it.
And Brand New Mad Men is exclusive to Sky Atlantic HD.